It's good. It'd be better just to be an honest person, but this is better than the other route where you just keep covering up. And I don't want us to get off on the wrong foot. I want to, you know, trust is implicit in any relationship. So they lived in Bamburgh on the Northumbrian coast, and in Bamburgh. In the 80s, there was a spate of livestock eviscerations, and eventually they put this down to the Bamburgh beast. The whole industry, gift shop industry, grew up around this Bamburgh beast, and it's presented as a huge, great big, like, googly thing, many tendrils and wheels. And actually, in about 1984, 1985, a farmer ran over the beast on a moped, and it turned out it was just a tiny little thing, like a very mini, about the height of a very tiny, tiny boy. And it was just basically like a tennis ball full of small intestines, with a one protruding hoof with a Masonic logo on the base of the hoof. So that was a bit of a disappointment, but all of the villages along the Northumbrian coast have a beast. I don't know if the same applies here. I saw the beast of Melbourne, and it was just a dirty flag. That was Beast Bamburgh. The next village along is Monkhouses, and their beast is a bit shit. It's a dog that runs out of the sea at midnight for an hour or so, and runs around, and then runs back into the sea. Seahouses, which is another mile or so up the coast, their beast is 4 miles of string with a paper cup attached every 4 or 5 yards or so, and the paper cup whispers insults to everybody who lives there. Which is why, if you ever visit Northumbria, you'll notice people from sea houses have a little bit of a chip on their shoulder. which brings me to the Beadnell, the next town along there. Their beast is just a bag of chips. Anyway, this is the Bamburgh beast.
Thank you.
Monday night in Perth. Is Monday Saturday? It's just Monday. It's the same in Newcastle. Monday is just Monday. No. Changes. In Melbourne, Sunday, I don't know what Sunday is, but Monday is Sunday. But I don't know where Sunday went. I don't think they do Sunday. It's all arbitrary anyway. Every day is new. And also time is an illusion. Very important. Time doesn't exist. The only reason we experience time is because we have bodies we need to navigate through space, but apart from that, it's inconsequential. Riding through Yorkshire, we come upon the ghost of a tree at Buddha Tubbs Pass. Golden and green, flapping its leaves, though it is winter and there is no breeze. Seven little sparrows, pale as soldiers, hopping in amongst the curling boughs. Then comes a shout from one of our party, old Albert Bousfield's fallen down a hole. Hope upon hope, fastened to a rope, not able to ascertain how deep it goes. Albert, can you hear me make a sound? If you can't make a sound, then clap two stones. Leaving behind our friend in the lime pit, we hurry on in quiet dread into the fog, smothering the deers. The raindrops are falling like the bars of a jail, buried in the arsehole of the world. A row of burnt out huts, we made our beds. Lying awake, looking up through the black wooden beams, I can see the Milky Way. Comes there a scream out of the sky, a great ball of fire goes hurtling by. Everyone's awake now, what the hell is happening today? It's all so queer. Rising at dawn to find Thomas Knox has not from his sleep been summoned forth. Face like a mask, fixed in a gasp, we wrap him in blankets and we cover him with grass. Onward with our journey through Tao Lo and over Headley Hill past Hanging Stone. Called on an inn to fill our bellies with dark bloody meat and sour black beer. There we were warned never to stray far from the road through Cayo Bog. Several of the children from the village disappeared last month without a trace. 3 hours later, we go in single file through a maze of moaning soil, reeking of dung, droning of flies. The moss on the trees goes as we pass by. There is something awful alive in this place we are most relieved to leave behind. The moon is a peach in the brown fields of Kibblesworth. It won't be long till we get home. Cramp in our guts, bile in our throats, mischief undulating
through our bones. Suddenly the city lights around us, disappearing up into the clouds. Seven little sparrows, pale as soldiers, hopping in amongst the curling boughs.
How are we doing? Cheers, pal. How are we doing for time?
You completely disregarded time.
Now that's true. That's a good heckle. I'm usually quite low on tolerance for a heckle, but that's very good.
10:20.
Fucking what? No, French. 10:20. Maybe squeeze a couple more in.
Yeah.
Yes!
Yeah,
woo!
This song's called Judas Iscariot. Judas is a very fascinating character in the Bible. In many versions, he's so guilty after he betrays Jesus that he commits suicide. I like the version where he gets caught in a narrow alley and a wagon goes over his belly and his guts explode out. That's a pretty good story. Also like Lot's wife, when she looks back and turns into a pillar of salt. That's a pretty good one. But my favourite, I like Thomas, Doubting Thomas, because all the other disciples were just so made up when Jesus got back up from the cave. Like, hey, lads. And you're like, that is typical Jesus. That is brilliant. Whereas Thomas hung back. Yeah, he was pleased to see him. But he hung back and just waited till there was a quiet moment and took him to, well, Jesus, can I just have a little word? Maybe we want to go out on the veranda or pantry. I don't know if they had pantries back then, but the equivalent. And have a little smoke out the back of the cave. Can I just see the stigma there? And he's like, yeah, no, no problem. Could I put my finger into the wound? And that's why I like Thomas, because he refused to just believe, you know, the hearsay, but also because he was a little bit of a pervert. This is about Judas.
Thank you.
Well, it makes sense in the greater context of things.
Get over it.
Harry's here, he is. Take care. Lots of love. Folks, gather the beautifully enigmatic Richard Dawson. Another round of applause, please. And for all of their transformative performances tonight, please let us thank Richard, Basic House, Robin Yenting, and Kate. Another big round of applause for all of them. Sadly, that is the end of Liquid Architecture 2015 in Perth. In fact, pretty much the end of Liquid Architecture 2015.
There's more.
There's a bit more. Almost the end. So we can't announce that then. But it is definitely the end of Liquid Architecture in Perth. And thanks to Annabelle LaCroix for coming over and guiding us through the evening, and to all of Annabelle and Joss, sorry, I've got names mixed up. Joel Stern, sorry, I did that last year to Joel, actually. To Annabelle and Joel and all the team at Liquid Architecture for keeping it alive and making it a great annual national event. We thank them all. Round of applause, Liquid Architecture. And now I can correct the mix-up and thank Jostin Myberg and Petro Veras for making it all happen here at the Hellenic Club, and thank the Hellenic Club all in one go, so we can do one big clap for all of that. And of course, thanks to NEAF, the National Experimental Arts Forum, that's on tomorrow. You'll all be there, especially at 9:30 in the morning for Cat Hope's keynote. Oh, there's silence. What's going on? Fantastic. Yes. If you didn't go to NEAF today, get on down to the Art Gallery at 9:30 in the morning, and you'll find out all about it. Otherwise, it's neafneaf2015.org, I think.
Is it at the Art Gallery? I think it's at Central.
Kate, who's yours?
TAFE.
Oh, sorry. It's at TAFE.
Yeah, tomorrow.
At the Central Gallery.
Yeah,
10
o'clock.
I didn't get it right at all. Look it up, too. Well, okay. Well, get on down to Cat Hope's keynote at Central Gallery at 10 o'clock. Yeah, beautiful. And so look up NEAF2015.org. We're back here at for another NEAF event. Well, it's part of our special club, so I mentioned tomorrow night, put together by Petro Veras. It's called Hellenic Echos. It's a special celebration of all the young Greek new music composers and performers. Strange collective, large percentages of them are here in Perth, but here at the Hellenic Club, so we're looking forward to that sort of wind-up of NEAF as well. Otherwise, go to tura.com.au. Thanks to the City of Perth again for supporting these two nights, and we'll see you soon. Cheers, bye.